Hello, welcome again. We are solving the topic is thermodynamics, thermal property of solids and kinetic rate gases. Question number 25 from the year 2020. A Carnot engine having an efficiency of 1 by 10 is being used as a refrigerator. If the work done on the refrigerator is 10 joules, the amount of heat absorbed from the reservoir at lower temperature is options 100 joules, 299 joules, 390 joules, and 41 joules. So this is your engine, Carnot engine. This is higher temperature given and heat is being supplied to the engine, and work is done by the engine W, and rest of the heat is ejected Q2 at temperature T2. So W is your Q1 minus Q2. And as this is the Carnot cycle, so efficiency is also given by this T1 minus T2 by T1. Okay. And that is equal to W by T1. Okay. So hot T1 is your hot reservoir temperature and T2 is your cold reservoir temperature. So T1 minus T2 by T1 is your 1 by 10. Okay, 1 by 10. Okay, and this is your 1 minus T2 by T1 is equal to 1 by 10. So T2 by T1 is equal to 9 by 10. Okay. So now this engine is being used as refrigerator. Okay. So now in the refrigerator we are extracting heat from the lower temperature. So heat extracted, so just reverse of this. Now here heat addition at T2 is Q2. Now here heat rejection will be at T2 and the heat addition will be at T1 and W will be work input. Okay, so this is just reverse of this refrigerator is reverse of this engine. Okay. So this is W. And in this case the COP is taken. So COP is the depleting effect, or heat-to-depleting is depleting effect divided by work done. So here the depleting effect is Q2 and work input is W. So this is your Q2 by W. And similarly, as we have taken this W as T1 minus T2 and Q1 as T1, so we can also take Q2 as T2. And W as T1 minus T2 in case of Carnot cycle. Okay. So now T2 by T1 is 9 by 10. Okay. So we are taking this and dividing T2 on both sides, T1 by T2, this is minus 1, and this is T2 by 10. So this will be 10 minus 5 or 5. 2 minus 1, 1, okay, so it will be 1 by 2, this is your 10 by 9, okay, this is your 10 by 9, so it will be 90 degrees, so it is 10 by, because T2 by, T1 by T2 is your 10 by 9, okay, so it will be, it will be your 10 into 90 by 10 into 9 by 1 will be 90 joules. Okay. So Q2 will be your 90 joules. Option 3 is the right answer. Okay, next, consider a mixture of n moles of helium gas and 2n moles of oxygen gas. Molecules taken to be rigid as an ideal gas, its CpuSCV will be equal to option 1 67 by 45, 2 23 by 12, 3 19 by 10, 13, 4 40 by 27. So in case of helium, for helium which is monatomic gas, Cp is equal to pi by 2 R and Cp is equal to 3 by 2 R. Cp is equal to pi by 2 r, and okay, for monatomic gas, this is the value of Cp, here Cp is your n by 2, and n in monatomic gas is 3, so you can find out Cp, Cp then will be 2 plus 1 plus, okay, that will be pi by 2 r in case of monatomic gas, and in case of this oxygen which is diatomic, the Cp is your pi by 2 r and this will be 7 by 2 r. Okay. So now considering mixture, so mixture of helium and oxygen, so this will be your 2n plus n is your 3n, 3n into Cpm. Okay, taking Cpm is mixture of Cp of mixture. And n into pi by 2, so this will be your Cp of helium, because there are n moles of helium, so n into pi by 2, so r, and there are 2n moles of your oxygen, so this will be 2n into pi by 2 r, and total number of moles of the mixture will be 3n, so 3n into Cpm is equal to this quantity. And similarly, 3n into Cpm of mixture will be n into Cv of helium and Cv of oxygen. So gamma will be Cpm by Cvn. So will be 5 by 2. 5 by 2 plus 7. 2 is involved and divided by 3 by 2 plus 5 is 19 by 13. Option 3 is the right answer. Option 3 is 19 by 13. Next, consider two ideal diatomic gases A and B at same at same temperature T. Molecules of the gas A are rigid and have a mass m. Molecules of the gas B have an additional vibrational mode and have a mass m by 4. The ratio of specific heat CvA and CvB of gas A and B respectively is option 1, 3 by 3 ratio 5, 2, 5 ratio 7, 3, 7 ratio 9, 4, 5 ratio 9. So first of all, taking molecules of A, so this will be Cv is your m by 2 Kb T Na. And this can be recognized, Kb is Boltzmann constant, and T temperature, Na is number of molecules, N is mole energy divided. So Kb T Na is your RT. Okay, so for 1 mole, K N by 2 RT. So N is your degree freedom, and 1 is your molecule. As A is your diatomic gas, so it is a degree of freedom for this is 5-3 translation to rotational. So CBA is your 5 by 2 RT. And in case of second gas that has a 1 vibrational mode also, so this will be your N by 2 plus F into RT. So N by 2 is your N is your 5 and F is your 1. So this is 5 by 2 plus 1 RT. So this is 7 by 2 RT. So CVB is your 7 by 2 RT. And CV by A by CV of E, you can find out the ratio. CVA is your 5 by 2 RT and CVB is your 7 by 2 RT. So ratio is your 5 by 7. So answer is 5 ratio 7. Option 2 is the